If you're an Amazon seller based in the United States, you could be missing out on the potential profit and increase of sales by 1 to 5%. If you want to expand to countries such as Canada and Mexico, so really fulfill that North American continent, you are able to do so through Amazon's NARF program, which is the North American Remote Fulfillment. And it's very simple to do. You don't have to go through hoops and hurdles of opening a new account or having a different listing for each product that you sell. NARF has made it really easy that if you're already an Amazon seller, to easily add these countries to your market. And it is so great. Can't believe that more people are not talking about this, so I'm gonna go into it so that you can start seeing increased profits. In order to easily and better understand how the NARF program works, I'm gonna break this down so that I can highlight the pros and cons of doing so and adding this to your selling plan. Amazon is taking all the taxes and duties across the border, so I know that it's really stressful to think about, well, how am I going to expand to another country if I don't know how the rules and regulations work? But with Amazon's program, they've really taken care of that easiness for you, making it just like a no-brainer to transfer your product over and fulfill through Amazon to continue to do so. There's ways to test out customer base in Canada and Mexico, right? So if you have the option to do so, you definitely should. This is a good way, and without having to spend even extra crazy amounts of money to expand to these markets, it's gonna be a great way to test this in Canada and in Mexico. Now, this can add to your sales monthly. So the great thing is that this can be a good way to expose your product to new customers and then in turn increase your profits. But just remember that nothing is guaranteed. It doesn't mean that you're going to, you know, for sure get more money or more sales per month, but why not try this option and see if that would be the case for your product? So that's definitely a pro to have an easy way to expand. The great thing too, the fact that this is through Amazon, if you're already very comfortable selling on Amazon, this is a very good, less risk of an option. So this is going to save you time and money in the long run because you don't have to worry so much about inventory logistics if Amazon's taking care of everything. It's being fulfilled from here in the US and it's going to show up on your account the way it does for any US sales. You'll be able to have access to easily see the US, Canada, and Mexico at the same time and what the sales are for each of those places. So there's not an extra thing that you have to do. You're really not paying much more or, you know, having to go through extra steps like I mentioned. It's going to be easily accessible through your US seller account. The great thing too is that Amazon is taking care of optimizing your listing in Mexico. So it's going to automatically translate your listing for the Mexico market. And that is a huge, huge plus and a weight off of your shoulders. You don't have to do anything extra. So I am just blown away by how easy it is to apply. Now with pros, there's always some cons. So I think that's the most important thing that I want to focus on in this video so that you are very much aware of what can come about when having to expand your market. So one thing would be possible hidden fees. Even with your account here in the US, there's always some small other fees that are unexpected. Sometimes there's gonna be months where you're paying more than others. There's always something with Amazon FBA. That's kind of just the price we pay for having the easiness of having Amazon sell your product. For the first con, the hidden fees, I wanna remind you that there's just no such thing as a free lunch. So customers might be experiencing some import fees if you're selling from the US. And say that your listing is for $29.99, they might see that on there, but they might have to pay some additional import fees. So each country is very different with that and how it's handled. Perhaps most Canadian customers know about these fees already and they're not affected by selecting your product. They know what to expect when things are coming from the United States or anywhere else in the world. Perhaps they have that knowledge already. But this can create some tension between your customers and your product if they see a $29.99 listing product, but then they have to pay any additional charges adding up to perhaps $40 or much more than what they expected to pay. From a seller standpoint, however, Amazon does take care of these import fees. And so any fees that the customers are seeing, Amazon will take care of, and that will be reflected on your overall fees that you pay Amazon each month. So it's kind of a nice thing if it's not really that much more. It actually does just depend on your product, the size of your product, what you're selling, and all that good stuff that you probably already know for your US listing. But the fact that Amazon continues to take care of those fees for you, you don't have to kind of do extra research or think about how much those fees are going to cost you. Just do remember that these fees might cut into your monthly margins as well for your product. So there's a lot to consider there. Just check it each month and again, make adjustments so that it fits with your business plan. So in the last page, you'll see that you have the option of FBA and FBM. Your FBM quantity will show as zero to start, but this won't be the overall reflection of what you have. That is if you're pursuing FBM. With FBA, it's not a concern, especially for me since I do have an FBA account, but it will definitely be important to take note of if you are doing both or just FBM. So just be mindful of your inventory, and like with any product that you have listed, you want to just check on it regularly. Make sure that everything is going smoothly, but again, through this transition of using their NARF program, there shouldn't be any really additional steps that you need to take. It's just more of monitoring and checking and making sure that everything makes sense with your business. So the great thing about setting up this North American remote fulfillment is that you have now a product available in two extra countries. So you have Canada, the US, and Mexico to open up to customers and hopefully gain more insight and looks at your product. I mean, that's a huge plus without having to go through a long and costly process either. So it is a no-brainer if you are an Amazon seller in the US. If you have any experiences with NARF different than what I'm describing or have additional questions, I'd love to hear about it. Share it in the comments below. We can help each other out, and hopefully anyone that wants to look into NARF, they can see kind of the experiences that we've had and have this platform be a way to share all of our different experiences that we may encounter. But overall, hopefully it is a seamless process for you guys. I'm so excited that Amazon has made it really easy for us to do so, just to expand our market and see how everything goes. So if you guys like this video, hit the like and subscribe button so that you can continue to see more content on what I'm learning through this Amazon FBA journey. If you want to check out more about my story and what product I sell on Amazon and how it's going so far, you can check out the other videos here, and I will catch you in those. See you next time.